are here to enact the English play named Pandora's Box. According to Bible, the first man and woman on earth is Adam and Eve. But according to Greek mythology, the first most beautiful woman on earth is Pandora. There are many similarities between the two, and they are both of these women are held responsible for bringing evil or sin into the world.
Moving into this narrative story of Pandora, sent by Zeus, god of gods, to punish the brothers, Prometheus and Epimetheus, for stealing fire from Zeus and giving it to mankind. Now let's watch the play and understand how cruelly Prometheus is being punished and why Pandora is created.
Now the scene opens with Zeus conversing with the Titan brothers Prometheus and Epimetheus.
Prometheus and Epimetheus, I have a task for you.
A task? What on earth, my lord?
Actually, you're right. I have a task for you on earth.
What task is that, my lord?
Well, go down to earth and fashion new men and beasts.
How can we do this, yes?
When you arrive at earth, simply go to the river. Use the clay on the bank to create new mortals, both human and animal. You will see it works well. As you work, you can give each creature a gift to make them swift, strong, or whatever traits you see is fit to bestow.
Yes, yes.
The brothers journey to earth and begin to create many creatures.
As was his nature, Prometheus took great care in fashioning each man in the image of the gods.
And Epimetheus created the animals, working as quickly as he could.
Why are you so slow, brother? Look, what happened in half a time? It's taken you to make one mortal.
Good work, takes time, Epimetheus. Men deserve to have the best in the life. Don't you know that?
Unfortunately, Prometheus was so slow that Epimetheus used up all the good gifts on the animals he created.
They could run fast, see far, and hear from great distance.
They also had warm coats of fur, while the men were left to shiver at night. Taking pity on his creations, Prometheus went to Zeus for help.
Yes, my men have kept me from them, but they need warmth and a way to prepare their food. Won't you share your sacrifice with them?
What do you think? Am I a fool? The fire is meant only for the gods, not for a lowly mortal. Get back to your work!
Prometheus sneaked up to Olympus, stole an ember from the fire there, and gave it to the men, warning them never let it die. The fire not only kept the mankind warm, but also the beasts at bay. Before long, the men learned how to kill the beasts and cook their meat. The smell of the roasting meat drifted to the heavens, alerting Zeus for Prometheus' betrayal. He summoned Prometheus to his home.
Prometheus has betrayed me. He has stolen fire. I will teach him a lesson for life. I want to make him immediately.
Theseus,
you have disobeyed me, Prometheus. But I have a proposal for you.
And what is it, Zeus?
To the men share whatever delicious meat they're preparing with me. Then perhaps I will let them keep a part of the meat with themselves, along with the fire that you stole from me.
Okay, Zeus.
Prometheus returned to the martyrs and gave them careful instructions.
My dear people, Zeus is asking for personal aid. You are cooking. Tell us what I propose. Butcher an ox and divide the meat into two equal parts. Put the fine meat in one sack with the entrails on top. Then put the fat in one sack with the bones. I'll give Zeus a choice. With some good fortune, he may choose the wrong side. Go and start working immediately.
To see us with an invitation.
Yes. The men have prepared two portions of the ox. Why don't you choose one for yourself so that the men can carry the mice?
Indeed, when Zeus examined the sacks, he assumed that good meat lay underneath the fat and chose accordingly. He was furious when he realized he had been duped.
Prometheus! You have tricked me for the last time. You are to be bound in chains at the top of the Caucasus Mountain. And this doesn't stop you. Every day, an eagle will come down to the sun and dine on your liver.
No, Zeus, please don't do that.
And I have another punishment in mind for precious mortals too.
No, please don't punish my mortals. They are innocent.
Gods!
Now, Zeus is punishing Prometheus with most cruel punishment that his liver will regrow every night and an eagle is scooped from the mountain and dine on his liver. After a few months, Hercules passes through the Caucasus Mountain and finds Prometheus being shackled.
Hey, you, Prometheus? What has happened to you?
Zeus is punishing me.
I think I can help you. But first, I should ensure that the eagle no more torments you.
Who are you? I think you are the strongest man.
Yes, I am. I am Hercules, son of Zeus. I am the strongest man in the world.
Is it?
Until this time, all mortals were men. Zeus decided it was time they had a woman as a justice for it.
A woman?
Why, father?
Don't ever dare to question my decision. It's an order.
But father, making a woman is harder than making armor for Mars or to have a statue for Anna.
Don't hesitate. Just do it.
Yes, father. I'll start right away.
Thank you.
a beautiful actress. You did a wonderful job. I will give her a bell full of pearls and purple dresses with precious stones.
Yes, Anna was right. I truly admire her. I will give her a gift of generosity, charity and patience.
You are indigenous, creative and intelligent. I can see that from your masterpiece. I give her wisdom.
She is already so beautiful, so I will give her the gift of love.
She is gorgeous. I will give her flowers, jewelry and a little bit of curiosity.
By adding to her pride, I give her music from the most precious thing, and she will be known for her own way of music.
I will give her persuasion, strength and stamina.
Now goddesses is intrigued about Pandora's creation and goes to Zeus for explanation.
Wow, how radiant she looks. She is flawless and vibrant.
She is so elegant.
Hey, stop. She is not as beautiful as Pia.
But wait, why did Zeus decide to make a woman?
We are in pandemonium. Why did he create a woman? Are we not enough to decorate the Olympus?
Yes, and know the reason why he created a woman.
Well, we will meet him and let us know the truth.
Wow, it's a surprise to see all the goddesses together.
Zeus, we all know you do everything with a purpose. But did you make a woman to envy us?
No, certainly not.
But we are so confused. And we would like to know why you have created a woman.
I will let you know why I created her. I created her to punish mankind.
But wait, why do you want to punish mankind?
According to me, mankind is filled with cruelty. And moreover, Prometheus has stolen fire from me and gave it to the mankind.
But I don't understand what's wrong in you, Zeus, in sharing the fire with mankind.
The fire is meant only for us. Am I right, my beautiful goddess?
Yes,
yes.
We all will obey your words and do as you wish, Zeus. Thank you, Zeus.
Now, Hephaestus take Pandora to the Zeus.
She's a beautiful woman I have created.
Incredible! She's perfect. And I can see all the goddesses already gave her gifts.
Yes, they did.
Very well. And now it's my turn. The name will be Pandora, which means the all gifted.
Long live Pandora! Long live Pandora!
But I shall give you this box. You must take this box with you when you go down to Earth.
It's the same, but beautiful box, yes?
It's more than that, Pandora. It's an extremely special box.
Tell me more about it, please, my lord.
As you can see, Pandora, this box is extremely beautiful on the outside. It's made up of pure gold and studded with diamond and sapphire.
And it's so heavy. What is it?
I can see that Diana gave you curiosity, Pandora.
Just a little.
Anyway, it contains diseases, death, sorrow to humankind. It can make them suffer, cry, and even destroy them. That's why it's so heavy.
But yes.
Listen to me, Pandora. You must never, ever open this box.
I won't, yes, I promise.
If you open the box, all the diseases, pain will spread throughout the world. If you do as I say, they will not harm anyone.
I appreciate your gift, Zeus. It's so shiny and beautiful that I can't stop looking at it.
Now it's time for you to go. Fastest, tell the messenger god, Pandora is ready to leave.
Yes, father.
Listen, Pandora. When you go down, you'll marry a Prometheus. Prometheus is brother.
Prometheus, you're my creator, and I'll always obey you.
Now, messenger god, take Pandora to the Titan brothers, Prometheus and Epimetheus.
What are you doing here, messenger god?
Yes, let me wake up.